Hi everyone, in this video, I want to talk about how we can pass lists to Python functions. If you remember from a previous video, Python functions allow us to have a separated piece of code that we can call anywhere in our Python code. And upon being called, it'll activate the chunk of code that is our Python function. We also talked about what parameters and arguments of Python functions are. Just as a recap, remember that parameters are the pieces of information that our program requires, whereas the arguments are what the user gives to our function. So, in this video, what we are really doing is using a list as an argument to our Python function to satisfy a required parameter of that function. So, how do we go about getting our Python function to accept a list as an argument? Well, it is actually quite simple. So, to do this, let's create a Python function that prints out our grades for a given semester. Through this, we could create a few different lists that correlate to a couple different semesters in school. Obviously, this is a simple example, but it is just meant to give you an idea of how passing lists into functions works. Alright, so let's create our Python function called semester grades, which remember is initialized by this def term. Then we require two parameters. One is for our semester grades, and the other is for the courses taken in the semester. Since we are always going to have the same number of courses as grades, we need to extract the number of elements in either of our two lists. Then, just initialize an iteration variable I. So, let's say while I is less than our elements in our grade list, we print the following statement. Then we add 1 to our iteration loop counter, and this loop will continue while our iteration counter is less than elements in the grades list. That is all we need to do for now in our Python function. Alright, so now we need to create two simple lists that can be handed into our newly created Python function. Then, lastly, let's call our function and input our lists into our Python function using positional arguments. If you don't remember what positional arguments are, check out the video in the description below. Now, let's run our program finally, and we see that we receive a statement about all of our courses taken in a given semester, like expected. Alright, so you may ask, what is the difference between this function and the ones we used previously, where we only took in a single argument, rather than an argument list? Well, really nothing. As you can see here, if I remove the element identifier of our list, it'll print the entire list for each iteration. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of how we can pass lists into Python functions. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.